It's years since I phoned in to you. But one of the reasons was I was driving here and I heard the last caller saying about Dessers. There's a player in there. And as soon as I parked the car, I thought, I'm going to try and get through to Clyde because I really got to refute that nonsense.
Oh, I thought you were going to agree with him, Bob.
Oh, no, because he's been here 5 months. And if you don't know by now there isn't a player in there, you will never know. Because I keep saying this to people, everybody around me at Ibrox in the Sandy Jordan, they all agree with me. Nobody can stand the guy. He can't run. He's got no pace. He can't jump for the ball. The few occasions he does actually jump up, he heads it nowhere near the goal. He runs around a lot, but he never quite gets to tackling a defender. They always pass it on before he reaches them. As I say, he can't pass the ball. When he does get a chance to shoot, he's always caught in two minds. He doesn't know whether to shoot or to pass or to take another touch. And as often as not, the chance goes by the time he makes up his mind.
You do realise, Bob, you'll have to come on tomorrow night and apologise if he scores a hat-trick tonight.
Bob's just described Mark Wilson.
See, if he'd scored a hat-trick against Celtic, I still wouldn't be saying there's a player in there.
I just don't believe you, Bob. The player who scores a hat-trick against Celtic and plays for Rangers is an immortal.
Bob, I'm going to go all out on a limb here then and guess that you hope Rangers sign a striker this window.
Oh, I'm desperate for that. I thought they would have signed one, but now, and Dessers would only come on in league games at Ibrox when you're 3-0 up and you want to rest the real strikers.